Hi, everyone. Good morning. I'm HRC Youth Ambassador Val Weisler, and I'm here to introduce an incredible woman to you, Mrs. Jane Clementi. Jane and her family have taken their personal tragedy, losing their son, Tyler, to suicide, and turned it into an action against bullying and harassment. A devoted mother, registered nurse, and founder of the Tyler Clementi Foundation, Jane shares her story with parents and community members, encouraging people to not merely accept or tolerate LGBT children and youth like myself, but to celebrate us and accept us. Please join me in welcoming Jane Clementi. Thank you.
This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned up. Starting right now. I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes. Cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. No, I've still got a lot of fight left in me.
Thank you. That was an amazing introduction. Thank you very much. And this has been a great conference weekend. It's wonderful to meet new people and to get reacquainted with past acquaintances and friends. And I'm really, really thankful to Vinny for allowing me to share a little bit of Tyler's story here with you today. In September 2010, my son, Tyler Clementi, made national headlines. Tyler had just started his freshman year at Rutgers University when his roommate had webcammed him in a sexual encounter with another man. The roommate then tweeted about Tyler's encounter, inviting many others to join in and watch a very personal moment that should have remained just that, a private encounter. I can only imagine that those bullying actions by his roommate must have humiliated Tyler in front of his new dorm mates. This may have even made Tyler think that his sexual orientation might have been something to be laughed at or ashamed of. I'm sure that these bullying actions must have caused Tyler to feel very isolated and alone, actually very worthless and maybe even very desperate, because it was at this point he made a decision that we can never change or undo. On September 22, 2010, Tyler died by suicide. He was 18 years old. We've come to realize that Tyler continued to log in to the Facebook post and Twitter feed of the posts that his roommate kept posting, and Tyler seemed to lose all sense of reality, not being able to see just how special and precious he was. He wasn't able to see the support and resources that he had available to him. He must have been totally consumed by the words of people that were out there trying to humiliate him. And it's really important to remember that it's not the technology that was the problem. Technology is a really good thing. It speeds up communication. It helps us stay in touch with our friends and our family. But unfortunately, technology is only as good as the people who use it. And technology can sometimes be a useful tool, which we hopefully it will be in most people's lives, but unfortunately it can be a weapon of great harm and injury to many people and many young people today, including my son, Tyler. Tyler's situation and the end result may have been an extreme, but it is important to remember that all harassment and bullying has great consequences and can leave sometimes great painful emotional and physical scars. And sometimes they can even last a lifetime. And although we cannot go back and change Tyler's actions, we can move forward and work to change the mindsets and attitudes of people who think that those kinds of actions, those actions of setting up a camera or sending out tweets to come and join in and watch the show, are acceptable. Because that's why I'm here today, to tell you that those are not acceptable actions. I want to make that perfectly clear to everyone. And that is why my husband Joe and I started the Tyler Clementi Foundation. We want to end all online and offline bullying in schools, workplaces. Thank you. Yes, we want to end all bullying in schools, workplaces, and in faith communities. And that last part of that statement is very important to me. Faith communities is a really big part of my personal mission. Because unfortunately, when Tyler came out to me, I was not prepared for him to come out. And he did not seem to think that he could be gay and Christian. And sadly, I was not prepared with any great words of theological support or wisdom to share with him in that moment. And although my response flowed from my heart, as I said, I love you, and I know God loves you, unfortunately, we were in two very different places. Because later, after Tyler had died, I saw a text that he had sent about 5 or 6 days after that comment. And the words that I spoke out of love to encourage Tyler, unfortunately, he apparently heard as condemning. So my mission is to make sure that other parents are better prepared than I was. I believe young people, actually all people, but especially young people, must stop hearing messages that someone is broken, less than, or separated from God just for how God created them or who God created them to love. I believe our faith communities need to stop teaching and preaching these harmful messages and start focusing on the essentials of our faith, which to me are messages of hope and peace and forgiveness and love. The Tyler Clementi Foundation also believes that every school should and can be a safe place to learn and thrive. But in order for that to happen, we need to change the culture in many of our classrooms and in many of our schools. We need to learn to treat everyone with the respect they deserve, being kind and considerate to everyone in person as well as in the electronic world. Because I hope you know and realize that your character is reflected in all the areas that you enter into, and that is inclusive of the electronic cyber world. As leaders within our educational communities, you have the power and responsibility to clearly display and articulate the tone that you want in your institution. Teachers must lead with actions and words that declare and set a minimal standard of behavior in your schools. But even more importantly, I call on all of you student leaders here today to guide and shape the culture and climate of your schools, because it's a research-proven fact that students have the greatest power to change school culture and climate. According to a recent study, there was a 30% decrease in bullying in schools that use their most socially connected students to take a stand against bullying. To me, that means that bystanders must speak up and become upstanders. A bystander is someone who witnesses someone being harassed or bullied and does nothing about it. If you see something, you must say something. If you feel safe and know the individuals, speak up at the time of the incident. Of course, we don't want to put anyone in harm's way, so if you don't feel safe, or maybe you have spoken up and you just don't see any kind of impact from your words, then you need to report it to a safe person of authority. You need to tell an adult. I think you need to know your motives, because if you are trying to help and support another student, then you need to understand that telling is not the same as tattling. You're doing this to help someone. But most importantly, I think, is another person that you need to speak with, and that is the target. I think the target needs to have words of encouragement, make sure that they know that they are safe and that they know where their resources are. This could very well make the biggest difference in the situation. I think that this last step would have had greatest impact in Tyler's story, and maybe his story would have had a different ending. To take a stand against bullying and change your school's culture may sound like a really daunting and impossible task, but sometimes the smallest steps can have the largest impact. And we at the Tyler Clementi Foundation think we have the perfect tool that can help you on this endeavor. It's our new initiative called Day One Campaign. It's the perfect tool for leaders of your school community to use. Day One Campaign is a simple, innovative, research-based, and effective tool that's designed to prevent bullying before it happens. All you need to do is go to our dayonecampaign.com website, download the script and state specific, and then read the script to your group. It states specifically the behaviors, words, and actions that will be acceptable and which words are not. Have the leaders read it and then get an acknowledgement back from the group that they understand it. You will then probably most likely need to post it somewhere also so that you can refer back to it, because it's not a magic wand. But at least it sets guidelines and it sets behaviors that can be that will be accepted in your community. The next step might be to then allow individuals in your group and community to pledge to become upstanders as individuals. So as I leave you here today, I hope that there are two words that maybe will stick and resonate in your mind, and those are control and power. First, you have control to your own actions and words, and you can make your space safe, whether it be online or offline, and one of respect and kindness. Just like the golden rule, we want you to all to do to others as you would want them to do to you. That's why our bracelets for our foundation are gold, to help you remember that. I hope you find it in your bags to help you remember to be kind to others. And second is power. You have the power to create the change in your school's culture and environment to the one that you desire to live in and be surrounded by. So I hope you will partner with us and work together with the Tyler Clementi Foundation to create a culture of kindness and compassion in all the spaces and places that you go. Because there have been far too many Tylers, and we want to make sure that there are no more. So please remember to use social media wisely and for good, which for us is to follow us on Twitter, like our Facebook page, and go and pledge to become an upstander at tylerclementi.org. And if you want our downloadable script for day one, just please go right out to dayonecampaign.com and directly download the script. Thank you, and you've been a great audience, and I truly appreciate you listening to this. Thank you.